me see. Tim and Stacy would like to extend their sincere gratitude to all that have come today to make this a priority in their schedule, to honor their lives and their marriage, and in honor of their families. There are two chairs with roses in them on the right side to honor her. To honor her father, and to honor Tim's father and mother. So thank you so much for being here and being a part of the wonderful ceremony. Dear friends, we gather together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these friends and these family members to join this man and this woman in holy matrimony. It is an honorable state. It is instituted of God, and it signifies to us the beautiful union that exists between Jesus Christ and his church. It was Jesus himself, with the working of his first miracle at the wedding in Cana. He adorned the act of marriage, and he blessed the union that exists between a man and a woman. Please join me as we go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we know that you are the author of love, and that the love that we bear each for the other is your gift to us. It is precious in your sight, and it is captivating to our hearts. And on this most special of days, we realize that you are the giver of every good and perfect gift. Our prayer today is that you would always give Tim and Stacy the perfect gift of your presence into their lives. Would you strengthen them? Would you provide for them? Would you hold them in your love, that love that endures all things for your glory? In the name of Jesus, who endured all things for the sake of love, we pray.
Thank you.
It was Paul who told us in the church in Corinthians about love and about the special bond that it has each for the other when he wrote these words and told the church in Corinth these words. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but if I have not love, I have become a sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, then I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but if I have not love, it profits me nothing. Love suffers long, and it is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It is not puffed up. It does not behave rudely. It does not seek its own. It is not provoked. It thinks no evil. It does not rejoice in iniquity, but it rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things. Love believes all things. Love hopes all things. And it endures all things. Love never fails. And though now we see in the mirror dimly, but then face to face, now I know in part, but then I shall know, just as I am also known. And now these three abide, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Tim, would you grab Stacy's other hand and look deep into her eyes? And repeat after me. I, Tim, do take you, Stacy, for my lawfully wedded wife, to live in the holy estate of matrimony. I will love you and honor you and comfort you and cherish you from this day forward, forsaking all others, keeping only unto you for as long as we both shall live. And Stacy, as you look deep into Tim's eyes, repeat after me. I do take you, Tim, to be my lawfully wedded husband, to live in the holy estate of matrimony. I will love you, I will honor you, and I will comfort you, and cherish you from this day forward, forsaking all others, keeping only to you for as long as we're both saved. And Tim and Stacy asked me, as your friends and families, to be included in their vows. So what I want to do is to give you a charge as well. Will you, as their friends and families, will you do all that you can to secure a wonderful marriage in their lives, to encourage them, to uplift them, and to honor their marriage and their home? And you guys shall answer, we will.
We will.
Thank you. Okay. You guys have vows. Did you want to do that?
Stacy, I promise to love without reservation, to demonstrate that love in action as well as word, to practice honest and thoughtful communication, to challenge and inspire you to be all that I think you can, to make passion a priority, to trust in your love, to take ownership of my health and to care for yours, to celebrate joys and share sorrows, and be side by side for all adventures, rain or shine, all the days of our life.
And to demonstrate that love in action, as well as word, to practice honest and thoughtful communication, to challenge and inspire you to be all that I know you can, to make passion a priority, to trust in your love, to take ownership of my health and to care for yours, to celebrate joys and share sorrows, and be side by side for adventures, rain or shine, all the days of our lives.
I thank you for sharing Stacy with me and for welcoming me into your lives. I promise to be there for you if you need me and to support you in any way possible. I promise to do everything possible to contribute to the happiness of this family. I anticipate many years of joy, happiness, and fun activities together. Dylan, I make you the same promises. I thank you for sharing Stacy with me and for welcoming me into your lives. I promise to be there for you if you need me and to support you in any way possible. And I promise to do everything possible to contribute to the happiness of this family. And I anticipate many, many years of joy, happiness, and fun activities.
Promised myself I wasn't going to cry. Can I have the rings, please? The ring is deeply symbolic of the sacred experience of marriage. In symmetry, it is circular, and it is never-ending. It is signifying to us the enduring and the unending flow of love and admiration and happiness between man and woman. Though on occasion you may be separated by time or distance, the rings will always remind you that the love that you share is present with you. The ring is also symbolic of God's love for both of you, and how when we ask Jesus Christ to be the Lord of our lives, the fellowship that we share with God is complete and is brought full circle. Would you please take Stacy's ring and repeat after me? I, Stacy. I'm sorry, Tim. Take me, Stacy, to be my lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to honor till death do us part, and with this ring, I do that. Placing the ring upon Tim's finger, repeat after me. I, Stacy. Take you, Tim, to be my lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love, to honor, to cherish, till death do us part. And with this ring, I leave with.
Thank you.
Tim, Stacy. I want to remind you today, the relationship into which you have both entered into is more than just moonlight and roses. It is much more than love songs and the whispering of vows of undying affection. I remind you of the place in which this ceremony has taken place. It is beautiful, and so is this day. But marriage is so much more than just that, just one day. Marriage is much more in the eyes of God Almighty. In the eyes of God, your marriage is an eternal union. Yes, it is the clasping of hands, but it is also the blending of lives. And most importantly, the union of hearts. We both know that this can only be done by God. So if you will honor him, he will honor your lives together and the home in which you live. I remind you both that your marriage will always be fruitful for those that honor Christ. Tim, you may kiss the bride. You guys want to turn around? It is with great honor for me to be the first one to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Timothy Graham. Thank you.